To get started with this section, I'm going to drag my layers panel off to the right-hand side so I can have it nice and handy for when I need to select and make changes to different objects. We're going to use the different drawing tools to recreate each of the different icons that we have on our rounded rectangles. So I'm going to use Command and the plus sign, and then hold down my space bar to move over to the first picnic table. Let's get it large and centered up in the center of our screen. First, let's choose the rectangle tool, and with nothing selected, let's change our fill color to be black, and our stroke color needs to be none with the red dash going through it. On our main panel, we can click and drag a rectangle on top of our table. Let's do the same thing again by clicking and dragging the bottom portion of our picnic table. To ensure that both of these are exactly the same size, let's use our selection tool, the black arrow, select the top rectangle that you created, and let's open our transform panel. Under Window, open Transform. I can see that they're the exact same size by making note of the height of this one. So with this selected, check out the H that's here. It's 0.1319 inches tall. If I select the second rectangle, I can see it's not the same height value, so let's type that in, 0.1319 inches. Now they're both exactly the same height for both of the rectangles that we created. Let's choose our rectangle tool again, and I'm going to click and drag one of the seats off to the left-hand side. Again, yours doesn't have to be 100% perfect, but to make an exact duplicate copy, we'll choose our selection tool again, then hold down the Option, click and drag till it goes all the way to the right side of our seat. This is a good point to save, so we'll go to File and Save, and continue on. Let's reselect our rectangle tool and draw each of the feet by using the Shear tool. I'll zoom in a little bit more just to give you a better idea. I'm going to start down at the foot and click and drag up until the width of it matches the width of that foot. Now I want to make sure they're both exactly the same. So if I, with the rectangle still selected, check out your transform panel. We want to make sure that the W field is exactly the same as the other, and it's almost there. So it's 0.1319. Hit return. Now it's exactly the same width. To make this a slanted rectangle, let's use our shear tool. You can find this underneath the scale tool, which is located right here. So if we click and hold the scale tool, find shear, then going back to our little rectangle that we created, click at the very bottom right corner where it says anchor and hold for just a second. And this will put our new center point right here at the bottom right corner. Now, very carefully, we will click on the top edge and drag it to the right until it matches the same slant as the picture that we're copying. With it still selected, let's make a reflection copy of this. To do this, we're going to choose the Reflect tool. The Reflect tool is located underneath the Rotate tool. With it selected, you can double-click on this tool to bring up the options. And with it double-clicked, we're going to reflect this along the vertical axis. So with vertical selected, we'll keep the angle at 90. If you choose Preview, you can see what it will look like. And when we're finished, we're going to hit Copy to make a copy of it. Now that it's done, reselect your selection tool, black arrow, and let's move it into place on the right-hand side. Now let's see if we can clean up and make our artwork a little bit more manageable through grouping of layers. If we open up our layers panel, I'll drag it off to make it simpler to see. First off, we no longer need our template picnic JPEG layer. So with this layer selected, click on it and choose the little trash can at the bottom of your layers panel. This will ask you, are you sure you want to delete this layer? We'll say yes. And if we open up the icon art layer, by clicking on the little arrow on the drop-down side, on the left-hand side, you can see that this picnic icon is made up of multiple different paths and rectangles. Now, if I wanted to be able to quickly and easily select just the picnic table, it would be difficult because everything has its own separate layer. What I want to do is to group all of these together so with one click it gets everything. To do this, with the icon art layer selected, go to Select and choose All. Notice now everything is now selected, all of the artwork that makes up the picnic table. You can go to Object and Group, and this puts all of the rectangles into one single grouping together. Furthermore, we want to be able to group this icon with the rounded rectangle that's on the background layer. So let's open up the background layer. Remember, we can't select any of these rectangles because this layer is now locked. So let's unlock it by clicking on the little lock. Then we need to choose the appropriate rectangle. If I was to expand out our layers so we can see all of them here, here's all of the rectangles. I can hold down the Shift key and click once right here, and automatically you see that this little icon is selected, meaning this is the rectangle that we're working with. It also has our picnic layer selected. Now watch what happens if we group both of these objects together. Object, group. It took the rectangle away from the background layer and placed it into the icon layer. It moved it up. Furthermore, I can expand the group icon, and you can see that there's a group for the picnic and the rectangles inside of that group. So you can actually have multiple groups inside of multiple groups. Let's lock back down the background layer so we don't accidentally click on it again. And then let's highlight the top group that's here. We'll collapse it again. Double click it, and let's call this picnic table. And hit return. Once this is done, we can also collapse down our icon art. We're going to be repeating that same process every time we finish up each of the different icons that we're recreating. Now's a good time to save up our work, so let's go to File and Save and continue working on. I'll put our Layers panel back out of the way, and let's scoot over and use the line tools to recreate our little hiking man. Within our tools panel, let's go in and choose our line segment tool, which looks like this. We're going to set our fill color to be none, our stroke color to be black, and we'll keep our stroke at 1 point. The first thing we want to do is to draw the right side of his leg. So clicking at the bottom of his foot and dragging up to the top of his shoulder, just kind of eyeballing it, there it is for there. Now we can change the weight of this to be 12 point. So in the stroke panel at the top, type in 12 and hit return. You can see that it is a squared off line, so we need to change the line's profile. In order to do this, let's open the stroke panel. We'll go to Window, down to Stroke. By default, the stroke panel usually just shows the weight, but if you click on the little arrow, you can expand it to have much more options. Let's change the end cap to be rounded, so the cap should have a rounded cap. And now, since it's too long, let's open the transform panel, and let's change the length of our line to be exactly 1 inch. Here's our line properties. We'll set that to be 1. Hit return to finalize that. Now let's make another line for his left leg. Hold down the command key. Notice this will give you your selection tool temporarily. Click off of it, and when I let go, I'm back to my line segment tool. Carefully hover your mouse over the end of this line segment until you can see the word anchor. Notice that it's right there towards the middle of it, not towards the end of the line. So right about here. Once you see the word anchor, click and drag from there all the way down to the bottom portion of his leg on the right-hand side. Now let's do the same thing for his arms. Hold down Command, click away. We'll hover over till we find the anchor. We'll click and drag to create the first elbow. And before we create the second arm, let's change this out to be 8 points. So I've got that. Let's open up our stroke panel again. Let's change this to 8 point. There it is. Now we can click from the elbow point, click away, and drag to create the lower portion of his arm. Finally, let's change our, deselect it first, change our weight to be 4 points, and then we'll click and drag and create his walking stick. Now we can hold down the command key and deselect that. This is a good point to save up our document, so let's go to File and Save. And now let's use the rectangle and some live shapes to create the little backpack and his head. To do this, let's choose the rectangle tool. We'll set our fill color to be none. We'll set our stroke color to be black, but change our stroke size to be 1 point for now. I'm going to click and drag and approximately make the size of his backpack, but notice it's not slanted. In order to get it centered up perfectly, let's choose our selection tool. We can click on the center point and move it around. And if we move our mouse slightly outside of the edge, we get a little rounded arrow that allows us to click and drag and change the curvature of it. And we can also click on the edges to bring it in or up to get it roughly about the exact size. Again, it doesn't have to be 100% perfect. Now we can open up our transform panel again. And let's give it a rounded rectangle of 0.05 and hit return. And that'll round it out. We can now swap up the fill and stroke color, looking at the bottom of our toolbox, to fill it in with black and give it a stroke of none. Finally, let's create his head. Clicking on the rectangle tool, let's choose the ellipse tool. I've still got my fill set to black and my stroke set to none. So if I go over to his head, hold down the option key, you'll see a little circle appear in your in the center of your icon. Now when you click and drag, you can create a circle from the center point outward, and we want to create a perfect circle. Again, if you need to move yours around, you can use your selection tool and then move it into place and resize and reposition as necessary. I think that looks pretty good, so that'll be a good stopping point for us here. With this next section, we're going to join a couple of these line segments together. In order to easily see this, we need to go into outline mode. So I'm going to click off the empty area to deselect everything. Then I'm going to go to View and choose Outline. This will convert everything that we have into just the vector lines so that I can easily see it without the artwork getting in the way. Next, let's choose the Join tool. You can find the Join tool hiding underneath the Shaper tool. Here it is at the very bottom. With this tool, you can click and join together where any two line segments meet. For instance, where the elbow of his arm, these two are two separate lines, but if we click and drag over that area, it'll recognize where those two points are. And if we choose our selection tool, we can click on one of the lines, and now they're both selected as if they were one solid line. Let's lock this one down. So let's go to Object, Lock, Selection. This way we don't accidentally select that arm tool, and we'll join together the two left and right sides of his feet and body. Again, choose the Join tool. Then we're going to click and drag over where these two line segments meet. And now I can use my selection tool to click on one of them, and you'll notice that both of them are now selected. Let's go back to normal view. So I'm going to View and choose GPU Preview. And right now it looks like he's got a little spike going up his back. If that's the way yours is, that's okay. In order to get rid of this little spike, we need to change the profile or the outline of it. So choose your selection tool and click on one of the unlocked legs that we drew. Then we can go to our stroke panel off to the side and change the corner style to rounded. This will round off that corner. Now let's go back and unlock the arm that we created. Under the layers panel, we'll expand the icon art, and you can see here's the path that's got the lock symbol next to it. We can unlock it just by clicking on the little lock. Now, as with our picnic table, we need to manage and clean up a lot of our layers to keep this artwork simple. So I'm going to drag my layers panel out so we can see everything. First off, we need to lock down the picnic template layer. I should have done this earlier, so I'm going to click the lock for it so we don't accidentally make changes to him. Then, with the icon art selected, we can go to Select All. This will select all of the little hiker man. We can go to Object and Group. You can see he's now grouped in his own little layer. We can select the template layer for the hiker and choose the trash can to delete them, say yes to that, and we can open up our backgrounds layer and unlock the backgrounds because we want to hold down shift and select the rounded rectangle behind him. This way we have both the group for the hiker and the rectangle on that background layer. Now we can go back to Object and group everything together. Once we're finished, let's lock down the background layer again. We'll collapse it. Double click on the group, and let's name this Hiker. And as with the picnic table, let's lock down that one so we don't actually make changes to this one. Okay, now that we're done with the Hiker, let's move on to the camping icon. Let's get rid of some of these palettes and put our layers back off to the side. Now, for the tent icon, we're going to be using the Shaper tool to quickly and easily draw off these common triangular and line shapes. You can find the Shape tool underneath the Join tool, so click and hold on it, choose Shaper. And the deal with the Shaper tool is it allows you to quickly draw common shapes. So to draw the triangle of the tent, I'm going to start off at the bottom left-hand side and draw up, and then back down, and then back to the starting point. You can see that my triangle isn't 100% perfect until I let go of my mouse, and it gives me a perfect triangle in roughly the shape and size and position that I need it to be. Now, if yours is off by a little bit, that's totally fine. Later on, we're going to go back and make some changes, and I'll show you how to fix that. Let's draw another triangle for the door. And we can draw two straight lines for the tent poles. And you can also draw a little squiggle over an area that overlaps, and that will subtract that area from what's behind it. To make changes to the colors and the size and position of each of your objects, use your Shaper tool and click on the object. And in our case, let's get rid of the stroke. So we're going to change the stroke color to none. To change an object's color, click on, let's do the large tent, the large triangle with it selected. Change the fill color to black. Now to back out so that we can start selecting individual parts, I want you to click on it again, then choose the little down arrow that's to the right of your object. Now you can click on the inside of the large black triangle, and you get a bounding box that lets you adjust the position and size of it. So let's make this a little bit larger. More perfect looking, there's that. If you carefully select the edge of your white triangle, you get a bounding box around it, and let's make it the exact position it needs to be. So let's bring it up till we can see it. Again, yours doesn't have to be 100% perfect, but get it as close as you can for there. And finally, let's carefully click on the little tent pole lines, and we'll set those to have a black stroke of 4 point. Click the other little tent pole, set the stroke to be 4 point, and there's that. As with our other icons, we need to clean up and manage the layers. If we look in our layers panel, you can see that the shaper tool creates its own little shaper group of all the different lines and polygons that we created. So that comes in handy for keeping everything nice and grouped together. So let's pull our layers off so we can see what we're working with. First off, let's get rid of the template tent JPEG layer. Select it, hit the little trash can and say yes. We need to unlock the background layer. We can then select our shaper group, hold down shift, and select the rounded rectangle that's behind it. Let's go up to object and group them together. Finally, we can double click on the name of this group and we'll call this camping. And we'll lock down that layer and then lock down the background layer so that we can finally work on our last little icon. To draw with a pencil, we need to set our fill and stroke back to default. So let's choose the little white and black default swatch at the very bottom and choose the pencil tool. Now the pencil tool can be nested or hiding underneath the shaper tool. So here it is here. And we need to open up the pencil tool options. So double click on the pencil tool to open up these options. We want to keep the fidelity of it set to the midpoint. We want to check the close path options and we want to uncheck everything else. Now I'm going to keep everything selected and also edit the paths within a certain area. So I'm going against what the book says. You can do either one by unchecking everything or keep what I have. We'll say okay. With the pencil tool, this allows you to hold down your mouse and freehand draw specific shapes that aren't common everyday circles, squares, triangles, those kinds of things. So starting off at the bottom, we'll click and drag and follow as best as you can that flame shape. Now if you stop, you can always start back again if you have the settings that I have and redraw the whole thing. If you didn't use my settings, you need to draw this whole thing in one solid movement. It's one reason why I like to set those settings. And then back down to the beginning. There it is there. Let's also draw off this little white flame part at the very top. So click and drag, just get it as best as you can, back down to there. Then we'll grab our rectangle tool, it's hiding underneath our oval or our eclipse, and we'll click and drag and create this rectangle here at the bottom. Once we've got it done, let's go over to our layers panel. We can get rid of our template layer for the flame icon. We won't be needing it anymore, so let's click the trash can, delete it away. And what we need to do is we need to make a special grouping of these objects. We don't just need to group it together, we need to make a compound path. So choose your selection tool, click and drag over everything to get both the flame, the inside flame, and the little rectangle at the bottom. Then go to Object, Compound Path, and Make. And this will turn it all into one solid object so that when you swap out the fill and stroke colors, let's do that now, it should look like this. You should have a little hole where the white flame is and the rectangle should be treated as part of the object as well. With this one, that's all we had to do. Now let's go back to our layers panel and clean this object up as well. We'll unlock the background layer, hold down shift, and select the background rectangle. We can go to object, group them together, and then finally let's give it a group name of campfire. Hit return. Campire. There it is. We'll zoom back out and see the fruits of our labor so far. Now the final thing we need to do is to change up the colors of everything that's on here. And we'll do this by editing the individual grouped elements. We'll go to our layers panel and let's unlock all of the different layers that we have. So this way we can edit everything that's there. Let's choose the selection tool and try to click on the picnic. Notice that when we do this, our fill and stroke color is set to question marks. This is because everything has a multiple fill color and a multiple stroke color. We want to be able to select just one color. So to do this, we're going to choose the direct selection tool. The direct selection tool is the white arrow tool. With this tool, we can deselect our area by clicking off of it and carefully click on the brown of the rounded rectangle. With that one selected, we can go up to select the same fill color, and everything that has the same brown fill color is now selected. Let's open up our swatches panel again. I go into window and swatches, there it is. And let's change this to kind of a medium green. There's that there. We'll also set the fill color to none. So it should look like this. Now let's select any of the black shapes that we can. Using our direct selection tool, click away to deselect everything. Carefully click on one of the black shapes on the picnic table. Again, we'll go to select the same fill color. Everything that's that same color of black, we can now turn to white. But notice it didn't get anything that was made up of lines or inside of the shaper tool elements. So we'll have to work with those individually. First off, I'll zoom in. Let's carefully select one of the lines that we have. To do this, we're going to use the black arrow tool, the regular selection tool. If you click once on an object, of course it'll select everything that's in that grouping. But if you double click, it's going to go into a special mode called isolation mode. Within isolation mode, I can easily select anything that's just in that group and not select anything else. So let's double click one more time on the legs and isolate just those objects, just those lines that we created. Now I can select all of those lines. We're going to expand the group. So we'll go to Object, down to Path, Outline Stroke. This will convert your strokes to a fill color. Check out what you got on the side. Now with that done, we can set the fill color to be white. And to back out of isolation mode, click on the little arrow up at the very top. This will back us out until we get to our normal area. To change the color of a shaper content, we need to choose the shaper tool again. Click on the camp. Click on the color of the camp stuff. We'll change the fill color for this to be white, and then choose the individual little pieces, the lines, and change their colors to be white as well, carefully clicking on those. And there you have it. This should finish up the entire project for the book. Remember, you can do the other four icons as bonus for this project unit. When you're finished, go to File, let's save it up one last time, and you're going to upload this Adobe Illustrator file to the class Moodle page.